Hey, what's going on, guys? It's TMac here, and welcome to a new series that I have on the channel. We're posting our best league race of the week. This one was an absolute bang. It was round one ACRL in Australia. Yeah, this was an absolute banger here. I really want to get the season off to a good start. And it turned out pretty good. All of these are streamed live on Twitch, BigTmac_. Links in the description. Go check that out if you want to catch these live. But we do set a banker on the inters because I wanted to save a set of softs, which we then restarted the session. So that was just pointless. I should have just used softs, three sets of softs. But anyway, going on to our real banker lap, our first lap on the softs here. Going into turn one, I missed the apex a little bit. Go a bit deep. We keep it within track limits though, so it's okay. It's not ideal, but it's okay. As we put the DRS on coming down into turn three. And we break early here. We broke late for turn one and early for turn three. We get put off a little bit off the curb in turn three, and we completely understeer through there. We almost go off the track again. So this sector was not my finest work. It was to come onto the back straight, and I double stab again. You know, it's not a necessarily slow lap, but there's definitely time in it for my final run as we come onto the back straight. DRS flies open using our overtake. We've used about just over half of it for the lap. We're going to use a lot of it on this next straight here. Coming through, it's clean. It's not the fastest. I could have done a little bit better on that left-hander through the chicane as I spam the overtake as I open the DRS for the fourth and final time this lap. Actually, just kidding. It was the third time. We haven't opened it for the last time. That was... Oopsie. that was actually a really good corner, that right-hander, and it's flat around here. We break as late as we can while we still pitch the car in, and it come around to the last corner, which is almost flat again in qualifying. It's a decent last sector, considering the first two sectors weren't amazing. What time will it be when I cross the line? It's a 15.59. It's not a great lap time, but we're still only half a tenth from pole here as we start our final lap. Coming through turn one, let's see if we can improve. I mean, it's a little bit better, but I still hesitate turning in there. So we did lose a little bit of time, but we're still up on our previous best time. We break a little later here. Touch that curb nicely this time. Don't touch that red yucky part of the curb. And we get it turned in perfectly. That was no understeer there. Very fast through there. Look at that. We're already 0.2 up on our 15.5. 2.3 it says there.
What was that indeed?
What was that indeed? I just touched the curb a little bit too much and I've lost 0.3. I've absolutely spammed the overtake button. If you remember, I was 50% on the ERS this time on my best lap. We're already only at 25, so we've used a lot of overtake just to even keep it. And then we cut the track. We extend just barely. So this lap time is going to be null and void. Regardless, I still wanted to see what I could do. We hit that corner right. I think that would have been invalid anyway, to be honest. And then I do this. I lost another chunk of time by sliding the car out there. But we actually have a really, really good last corner here. So we actually do beat our time. It obviously won't count. It is invalid. But wow, that was really tough. We could have, you know, pole was a 15.280 as you can see here on the leaderboard. My face, my big head blocks it on the actual leaderboard. But yeah, it was a 2.80. We ended up qualifying P3 though, and we start on the hards. But wonder what tire everyone else starts on here.
Start. Is that a medium I see on research? Oh no, I'm the only hard runner. This is not good.
Yeah, well, that's not too great. Everyone around me starting on the mediums, but five red lights are on, and away we go. Obviously, I'm on the hards. It's going to be hard for me to get off the line here, as Pepsi already coming down my inside. I'm not sure what happened behind me, but it seems like a big gap from fourth to fifth here, as Trin manages to get into fifth. I'm not sure where he came from. He qualified all the way back down there, but I'm currently lost one position. I'm in fourth, but I'm on the hards, and I knew at this point of the race it was just... trying to stick in the DRS of the front pack with Magnussen Cube and Reese Fisher and Pepsi here. If I could stick with them on the hards, I knew it was going to be okay. But the hards on lap one were really bad, as you can see here. I was lucky not to get a warning here. You know, I just went straight off. But yeah, the hards were tough to drive on lap one. But you'll see in a little bit, it does come a little bit back in to me later in the stint. DRS gets enabled. Luckily, it only takes one lap before DRS gets enabled here, so it's pretty easy to stay in DRS of the drivers in front of you. But yeah, look at all that. Top six. Actually, it's a little bit more than just the top six in the DRS train right now. But watch out for Blicky. He was very quick. He didn't have a very good qualifying, but he is very quick, so he's one to watch out for behind me. But yeah, coming onto the DRS, as you can see, you know, 5.5 tenths, 5 tenths even before the first DRS straight comes out. So it should be, you know, Australia's a very DRS heavy track. So the thought is, as long as you can just stick within the DRS, it's so hard to lose it. It's so hard to lose the DRS here. So I knew I was safe once I got the DRS the first time. Although I make a mistake on lap two, out of the last DRS zone of the lap, and I look at the gap. It's 8.5 tenths. That's not ideal, especially considering I'm on the hards. But we managed to just about keep the DRS here. The gap's already over nine tenths now, and Pepsi, I think, realized it was 9 tenths away, and he's, look how close he is to reach the back of Reese Fisher. I think he wanted me out of the DRS. I don't think the people wanted me out. Pepsi, the front three, I think their plan was, medium tire, just run away as fast as you can from me behind, because I'll have the advantage. Or should have the advantage later in the race. But look, I've caught it in the middle sector anyway. And this is when I realized the hards felt horrible on lap one. They started to feel really nice already on lap three. And I thought, there's not going to be long till I get an advantage on these guys. And as you can see, the end of lap five, we skip a little bit ahead here. And I'm not sure if you guys caught that, but my tires were on 11% after, and we're starting lap six. They're not wearing. Luckily, I don't lock up too much on this game. And that's really helping me prolong the longevity of these tires. But we're really close to the lead now. We've got Trin and Blicky in our train, so it's just a six-man train for the lead. I'm not sure what's happened behind, but they've fallen out through battling or crashing or something. But yeah, we're sitting in a really good spot here. Top six, just clear of the rest of the field for the moment. Alrighty, as we come into the chicane on the end of lap six, Pepsi was a little bit slow there and he wasn't using ERS, so I'm going to try and make it down the inside, but I touched the grass, that slows me down a little bit on the straight there. I go down the inside, Pepsi was forcing me as well, just a little bit there. He wasn't using the very outside of the track, but he gets the outside line here and stays ahead of me. But I knew the medium tires were dying at this stage in the race. Look at Magnussen Cube as well with a big, big lockup. I knew it was time for me to try and start making moves. As Pepsi's first up, I feel like he was the most vulnerable. He qualified behind me, I think, at a little bit more raw pace than him at this track. So I needed to get him first. Once I was in third, I knew I could pass, double overtake the top guys.
But the problem is, it's so easy to maintain ERS, man. In these situations, it's fairly difficult to pass. Oh. But that makes it slightly easier. Okay, good work.
Great pass. That was very lucky. But now I realize, I'm in third. Pepsi unfortunately spun. I think he had wheel issues, so he was on like really, really low force feedback. Very tough for him, but I knew I was in third right now. I knew that I could double overtake. If I had a full tank of ERS on this back straight, I could get both of them. But Magnussen Cube goes down the inside of Reese Fisher into turn one, overtaking for the lead. That was a bit risky going side by side, and it's actually Blicky is past Trin behind, and now he's ready to try and overtake some people, including me. So that's what I also thought. I had to get ahead of these guys. I had to give myself some breathing room, just so I don't fall back even further in the pack. But as we come, we're on lap eight here. I'm on a full tank of fuel. ERS. Reese Fisher gets a penalty, and so does Trin behind. I'm only half a second away, and the DRS hasn't even hit yet. I said this is my chance to make the move for the lead. As we go by, Reese Fisher's not using any ERS. But we go past Magnussen Cube. He leads the race. I follow him straight through. Magnussen Cube backs out and lets me go through. Reese Fisher will still have DRS for this next straight. But he's not using any ERS. So I just go straight through and take the race lead. Easy as you like. I do take a bit of an inside line here. I wasn't fully clear into the braking zone. But no, I don't take the lead. I go wide. And through comes Reese Fisher to retake the race lead from me. Oh, he's compromised line. I almost hit him. As we come through to the second last corner, at least I still got Magnussen Cube, so I'm in second now. I can quickly pass Reese Fisher. Well, that was the plan anyway. On this main straight, and I do get it done. Do I get him clear before turn one? Yes, it was a very easy move, and I'll get DRS onto this next straight. Is there a possibility I can try and pull a second from Reese Fisher, considering he has no DRS right now? Be real. That's not ever happening in Australia. But as we come through to turn three, yeah, the move is definitely complete. And we are now the leader of the race on the hards. We skip to lap 10 here. We skip a full lap. Reese Fisher stayed behind, saving the ERS tank, I'm assuming. And look at me, I'm only on 64%. If Reese is on 100%, he can easily just overtake me. And I think that was the case here. As I look at him and I go, let's just work together. I'm not gonna try and defend this. I'm not gonna try and make it harder for you. and Reese Fisher retakes the race lead from me. But the important thing here was to try and keep Magnussen Cube behind. I wanted to be in second as much as I could, really, or first, just anything but third, as we stick behind. And yeah, we're fine. Moving on to lap 11, my tank's fully recharged. I was about 6 tenths behind Reese Fisher at the start of the straight. But I mean, look how close it is. I just use a little bit of ERS, and I'm well and truly back ahead into the back straight chicane on lap 11 here. So it looks like the hards are definitely the tie to be on here. Look, I'm only on 23% after 11 laps. I know a lot of these guys are probably on very, very worn mediums, maybe even 50% at this point on lap 11. So I was definitely in the driving seat here to definitely put myself in a good position by the end of the race. But as I go around the last corner on lap 11, Magnussen Cube and Blicky both dive into the pits to pit onto the hards. I thought that was very early, and I've just crossed lap 12. I thought that was very early to pit, but turns out it was a pretty good move from them. The mediums died quite quick here, and the hards were definitely the race tire to be on, as Reese Fisher on lap 12 goes straight by me with the DRS. And I think Reese Fisher stayed out because he wanted to get the DRS and leapfrog me into the pits to help prevent the undercut from happening, as he does dive into the pits on lap 12 as we lap Kirsch there, as we start moving on to lap 13. And I knew these were critical laps of the race here for me. I needed to get everything right to try and stop the undercut, but I slide out there a little bit. That's when the tires just started to die. I realized lap 13, there's been a crash behind me. It's Kirsch. I just lapped him, and a VSC comes out, and I knew it was okay. A VSC's fine. Me pitting on the mediums now would be very, very tough to make it to the end if a safety car was to come out. Oh, a safety car just came out. And this was it was quite difficult because it's end of lap 13. These guys only went 11 laps on the mediums. I've got to go 16 laps on the mediums now. But because it is safety car and everyone else is pit behind me, we're going to see where we come out here. The one saving grace with the safety car coming out is I'm going to come out of the pits. Look at the Haas, the white dot on the map. He's only just out of the last corner. I come out 5 seconds ahead of him. You know, massively ahead. So although my tires will be absolutely dead by the end of the race, I've got the race lead, and I've kept the race lead here. But something happened at the end of the safety car. I'm just checking race director to see what everyone's warnings are on. And I look behind me, there's Wing. And it was Magnussen Cube's Wing. Magnussen Cube hit Reese Fisher and gets a 10-second penalty as the safety car comes in this lap. I've got 13 laps to defend on the softs and on the medium, sorry, compared to the hards as we go green. Now, remember, though, the mediums only lasted 11 laps for the guys behind me, so these guys should have the massive advantage by the end of the stint. But can I maybe stretch a second to the guys behind? Magnussen Cube does have damage. Reese Fisher is on the hards. You know, everyone's on the hards behind me. There is a chance that I can pull a second. But I'll give a spoiler alert. I didn't. Reese Fisher had much warmer tires than me. During the safety car in this lap message, he was paused the whole time. His AI was warming up the tires, and I didn't really have the option to do that. I was leading the race. I had to dictate the pace. So Reese Fisher was very, very, very quick on that first lap of the safety car. So he manages to easily stay within my DRS. He does have that 3-second penalty, though. And Madison Cube behind does have damage with a 10-second penalty. So the race was still definitely in my favor here. As we come into, you know, lap 18, Reese Fisher does pass me. This was the second lap of the safety car. And I had to make a decision here. Did I want to try and pass Reese Fisher again and try and push that gap and push the tires? Or did I want to save the tires a little bit? Look at him. He was 7.5 tenths ahead of me here. But he never ended up getting out of my DRS. I said, I'm just going to save my tires, because on lap 29, if my tires are dead, there's no chance of me winning. If I can stick with these guys all stint, you know, I have a chance at on lap 29. But as I get past Reese Fisher there on lap 19, Magnussen keeps doing a brilliant job staying in the pack. Blicky's in the pack, but it's only four people. Only four people are in this pack right now, and one of them has damage, and another one of them has a pen. But as we go by Reese Fisher, he passes me here, and I notice Blicky goes into P3. He's 8 tenths behind me, though. So he's still a little bit of a ways behind me. Or so I thought. I didn't realize this. But look who's on my outside now. It's Blicky! Just like that, as he's gained over a second on me over this back straight. And he's into second place. And that was a massive mistake by me. I did not think he was that close to me. But yeah, I'm in third right now. Not in the position I want to be in. I would rather be first or second. But Blicky has overtaken me. But Blicky does stick behind Reese Fisher here on lap 21. And I thought maybe I make a move here. I fake the inside, go outside. Blicky defends. But obviously nothing's really come off it. I couldn't get the exit there. As we move on to lap 22. Look at these guys. These guys are pushing as hard as they can on these hards. The hards are by far the best race tire here. As Apex Studios retires, but no, VSC comes out. And Blicky makes a move for the lead of the race on Reese Fisher. He's leading the race now. But the exact same thing next lap. Reese Fisher is behind Blicky now. And I'm using a lot of juice here. This might have been a mistake. You know, I'm only down to 40%, and I should be keeping that ERS tank up almost 100% at all times if I'm the third man in the train, but I used all the way down to 40% there as Reese Fisher takes the race lead, and he's looking like he's trying to push, maybe keep me and Blicky out of the DRS. He does have a 3-second penalty, so he needs, if this is just train racing to the end of the race between us three, it's going to be impossible. Magnussen Cube also pit. He had damage and dropped out of the train. So it's just us three now battling for the win of the race. So we come onto lap 24 here. This was very important for me. My tires, you know, the hards were probably better at this point in the race already. You know, I'm on, this is the 10th lap I've been on these mediums since the safety car. And look at me making a lot. This is when the tires definitely, I could feel it just starting to get a little worse. Look, it's 8 tenths. If I don't keep DRS here, my race is over. I'm just going to finish third at best. Reese Fisher's going to pull 3 seconds from me, but... Oh, wow, and I don't take that corner very well either, but it looks like Blicky didn't take it well, too well either. He's only 6 cents in front of me, so I managed to keep the DRS here while maintaining almost 100% of the battery here. So I ended up not being too bad, as Reese Fisher was 1.1 seconds in front of me at the start of this straight. As we'll carry on to the end of the straight and see where he is. Look, he's not even 7 tenths in front of me here. We gain over six tenths just on that straight, using all the track limits there as well. As me and Blicky, it was just very easy to stick behind Save ERS and just stick with Reese Fisher here. Reese Fisher is a very fast driver, so it was good to show that I had good pace here. Although I am in an Alpine, which is technically a little bit faster a lap than every other car. But Blicky goes on the outside. It's lap 26 here. We've got 3.5 laps to go. He takes the lead of the race again from Reese Fisher. And he gets the DRS, so he'll be able to pull away a little bit here. Heading in to the last sector. I'm still sagging back a little bit. My tyres weren't fully dead here. Oh, but Reese Fisher goes for another move here. My tyres weren't too bad at this point. But I knew I still had to keep saving them. Just so I could be within a shot of the last lap. Reese Fisher does take the lead here. And he gets the DRS. So he's going to even pull a little bit of a gap to Blicky here on lap 27. Blicky, well, this is the part where I thought, hang on, we might be okay here. Blicky locked the rears there, so that's a sign of his tires dying as well. So I don't think he's been too great on the tires either. But so my tire saving might be perfect for the end of this race, although I go wide here. You know, my tires were also dying. So... it was very, very difficult. We've got two laps to go here in this race. Round one of ACRL. I want to be championship leader. I don't get to say that too many times. You know, I want to be leading the championship at any point in the calendar. As we go, two laps to go. Reese Fisher first. But he gets a 6-second penalty. He is definitely out of this race now. Unless me and Blicky absolutely just cause carnage and crash into each other. Reese Fisher's definitely locked into third place here. So it's going to be a dogfight between me and Blicky to see who wins this race. And my thoughts at the time here, my thoughts at the time were definitely, you know, I actually wanted Blicky to be leading into the last lap, so he would have no DRS onto this time next lap, so I could potentially try and overtake him into the 90-degree right-hander at the end of the next straight. But Blicky does stick behind here, and he's saving ERS, so... He doesn't look like he's going to go for a move on Reese Fisher here. As Reese Fisher gets a very good exit out of that chicane. And yeah, Blicky's not going for it. He goes a little bit defensive on... It might have been on me there, just in case I was going up the inside. But we're going to go into the last lap. It's going to be Reese Fisher first with 6 seconds of penalties. He is out of the race. It's going to be me and Blicky. But Blicky makes another mistake at this point. He told me after the race he was extremely nervous. which is very funny. How the hell are you, mate? How are you getting nervous because I'm behind you? I don't have that much aura on track. But we're onto the last lap of the race here, and it's still very, very, very tight. As to who will win this race, no one knows yet. You know, someone Blicky could make a mistake and through I go, or Reese makes a mistake and crashes, and who knows what happens then. But we're going on to the last DRS detection point, or the important DRS detection point. One of the final overtaking zones will be at the end of this double DRS straight, as Reese has an 8.5 tenths lead on me, and Blicky has a 4 tenths lead. So it's going to be very tight coming in. But will Blicky go for the move now? If he goes for the move now, it's over. Blicky wins this race, absolutely no doubt. But he doesn't. He sticks behind. He doesn't have the ERS to catch up to Reese Fischer here. So he'll have to do it on this next straight. But look how close I am now. I'm only 2 tenths back. Could I go for a move? Blicky starts blinking. I've still got a little bit of ERS. He goes down the inside, brakes late, and locks the rear. He slides. Reese Fischer goes through. Can I follow? No. Blicky defends from me. Takes the inside line here. Gets a terrible exit. I can't go. He defends again. I go around the outside, but don't brake late enough. And Blicky perfectly puts his car where he needs to, but he's still out of DRS here. Or ERS, sorry. So will I be able to try and maybe get anything on this last straight? No.
Fuck! He blocked me off barely on the corner. I should have dove down the inside. I had it, man. Fuck! I fucked it!
It was a very, very good battle. I just had the disadvantage at the end of the race with my tyres just being so much worse than the hards. It was unfortunate, but hey, my pace was good. End up getting P2. It's not a bad ending here. Not a bad ending at all. Grid Jokes Driver of the Day somehow. Blicky came from 6th to 1st and didn't get Driver of the Day, so don't tell me how that works. But yeah, that's Blicky on the podium, me in 2nd. You know, it was a good point to start the season. But yeah, that's how that race ended up. Gonna show the results here. My fat ass is blocking the way of the camera. But you know, Blicky first, me second, Reese Fischer third, Grid Jokes fourth, and that was the race. So that was it then for my first league race on F124 ACRL round 1 at Australia. Got a podium, can't complain with that, but I did get less than a tenth from the win, so it hurts a little bit that I didn't win the race in the end. But yeah, still a fun race. Shout out to Blicky for winning that first race. It was fun battling him. All these races are going to be streamed live on Twitch, twitch.tv/BigTmac_. So if you want to maybe next time try and catch me live. But other than that, that's everything for today. I'll see you guys for the next league racing video. Oh, and just one last thing. Enjoy the outtakes of Blicky's POV, of him winning the race, and my forfeit for letting him win the race.
So look at the speed. Wowee. Heavy breathing.
What?
He was freaking out. Wait, I'm playing this 1.25. I'm playing this. No wonder he looks so quick. I'm playing this in 1.25. Oh my god. No wonder he looks so quick. Yeah, you thought that was...
Yes!
Oh my god. Imagine I pass him on the line.
God.
0.095. Good. Oh, yeah, your last corner was good, Blicky.
My legs are shaking.
See this fizzing down? Beat your ass and hide the bottom. Oh yeah, baby. Sometimes you gotta pop out and show. Oh, hang on, I gotta. Man, I'm the one that up to score with him. Walking down. Oh my god, there's so much. I know he got some hoe in him. Pull on him. Okay, it's more than last time, but it's not the full bottle.
I hear you like him young. Evan, this is a fucking forfeit. Ready? Ready, guys, ready? Actually, I need a bit more. Hang on, wait. I'm waiting for the lyric, bro. Certified lover boy. What's spilling? Fuck him up. I'ma do my stuff. Why you trolling like a bitch? Ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord and it's probably A minor. I spilt it. They not like us. Bro, I spilt it, dude.